Good morning and welcome. Good to have everybody in the room and those online. We're going to read out of Matthew 6, verse 10, 8 and 10, 8 through 10. In this manner, therefore, pray, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. We're going to take some time this morning to worship and praise God, just like it says in this prayer that Jesus is showing to his people. And we're going to take time to worship him, and I invite you during that time to worship God by lifting up your hands, clapping your hands, standing, of course, in the house of the Lord, bowing before him. Don't miss out on any expression, any way to worship God this morning. You can dance as well. You can shout. You can sing. You can speak the wonderful, mighty praises of God. And then it says, Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I want to remind you this morning that, again, as I have in the past, in heaven right now, there is a heavenly host giving thanks, giving praise, giving honor to Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. And we want his kingdom here. The kingdom of God is within you. And you have the choice this morning to let his kingdom come, to give him glory, to act as the ones that are in heaven right now, giving him praise and honor. You can let that kingdom come to you now. I encourage you this morning, let's fulfill this word. Let his kingdom come to your heart. Let his kingdom come to you right now. In praise and honor to our God, let's stand. Let's worship him. Let's not lean on any person this morning, the worship team. Let's worship God ourselves this morning. I encourage you. Let's worship him. Amen.
Praise you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We invite you, God. Let your kingdom come. Lord, you're wonderful. You're wonderful. God, you are mighty, Lord. You are excellent, oh God. Worthy is the King of Kings. Is our wonderful King. We worship you, Lord. We call upon our King. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb of God. Worthy, worthy is his name. We love you. We love you, Lord. God, we thank you.
Father, let your kingdom come.
Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us, as we forgive the one who sinned against us. Forgive them. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Let your kingdom come. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us, forgive us, as we forgive the ones who sin against us. forgive them. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Let your kingdom come. It's yours, all yours, the kingdom, the power, the glory is yours. It's yours, all yours, forever and ever, the kingdom is yours. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us as we forgive the ones who sin against us. Forgive them. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Let your kingdom come. It's yours, all yours, the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours. It's yours, all yours, forever and ever, the kingdom is yours.
Father, let your kingdom come.
Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Praise, let your kingdom come. God, we need you, Lord. Word, we worship you, Lord. We exalt you, King of kings and Lord. Worthy, worthy is his name. Lord, let your kingdom come, O Lord. Oh, wonderful, wonderful, mighty God. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We exalt the King of kings. Thank you, Lord.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil while we're made.
Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. We are your church. We pray revive on earth. We seek your kingdom first. We hunger and we thirst. Refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace. We lay down our lives for heaven's cause. We are your church. We need your power in us.
Build your kingdom
here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire. Win this nation back. Change the atmosphere. Build your kingdom here.
We pray.
Unleash your kingdom's power. reaching near and far. No force of hell can stop your beauty changing heart. You make us for much more than this. Awake the kingdom seed in us. Fill us with the strength and love of Christ. We are your church. We are the hope on earth. Build your kingdom here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire. Win this nation back. Change the atmosphere. Build your kingdom here. We pray. We pray. Pray. We pray. God, we pray. Oh, build your kingdom here, Lord. Jesus, 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 Lord. Build your kingdom in your church, oh Lord. God, we thank you, Lord. God, we are reminded this morning, Jesus, your scriptures say, Lord, that you will build your church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. God, you're going to prepare a church who's glorious. God, you're going to make your church beautiful, a bride that to present to you pure and spotless. God, Lord, you're going to do a great work in your church. We are your church. We are the hope on earth. God, oh God, we pray. Right now in heaven, there is a host, there is a people that are praising and giving thanks to you. God, we pray, let your kingdom come. God, the people on earth need to match the people in heaven. God, make us that bride. God, make us pure and spotless before you, God. Jesus, we pray, let your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Let your will be done. In us, God, please, we pray.
We are that voice crying in the wilderness to prepare the way of the Lord. We're the light of the world, the salt of the earth.
I hear the voice of one calling. I hear the voice of one calling. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. Make it straight in the wilderness. Let his light shine. Let it shine in the darkness. Let his rain fall. Let it fall in the
gold is precious and the honey sweet.
So you love this city and
you love these streets. Every child playing by its own front door. Every baby lying on the bedroom floor. Every dreamer dreaming in their dead end job. Every driver driving through the rush hour mall. I feel it in my spirit, feel it in my bones. Yes.
You're gonna send revival, bring them all back home. I can hear that thunder in the distance, like a train on the edge of the town. I can feel the brooding of your spirit. Lay your burdens down. Lay your burdens down. From the preacher preaching when the well is dry, to the lost soul reaching for a higher high, from the young man working through his hopes and fears, to the widow walking through the veil of tears. Every man and woman, every old and young, every father's daughter, every mother's son, I feel it in my spirit, feel it in my bones. You're gonna send revival, bring them all back home. I can hear that thunder in the distance, like a train on the edge of the town. I can feel the brooding of your spirit. Lay your burdens down. Lay your burdens down. Oh, I can hear that thunder in the distance, like a train on the edge of the town. I can feel the brooding of your spirit. Lay your burdens down. Lay your burdens down. Revive.
Exalt your
reign in me. Sovereign Lord, reign in me.
Reign in me.
Reign in me.
Let's surrender unto him this morning.
Sovereign Lord, reign in me. Reign in me. Sovereign Lord, reign in me. Captivate my heart. Let your kingdom come. Establish there your throne. Let your will be done. Reign in me. Sovereign Lord, reign in me. Captivate my heart. Let your kingdom come. Establish here your throne, O Lord. Let your will be done. Reign in me. Sovereign Lord, reign in me. Captivate my heart. Sovereign Lord, reign in me. Sovereign Lord, reign in me.
Lord, this morning we invite you right now. God, we see the world's condition. Lord, we know that is a factor, Lord God, but we turn our attention, God, to us right now. God, and how we want to surrender ourselves that you would reign in us. Lord God, we pray that you would reign in our lives, in our daily lives. Jesus, that you would reign in our heart. God, that you would reign in the decisions that we make, the way we treat people. God, the way we treat you. Lord God, that you would reign in us, Lord Jesus.
Lord, in your kingdom, no one is mocking you. No one is rejecting your law. God, they are up there in heaven, and they give you honor and they give you glory. And Jesus, this morning we pray, God, that we would have that kingdom in our hearts today. God, that you would reign in our individual lives. Let's pray that prayer together, just asking God to reign in our hearts, inviting him to reign in us. Let's lift up our voices. Jesus, we come before you. Lord, we pray. Lord, as one. God, Lord, that you would reign in our hearts. God, Lord, not the kingdom of darkness, not Satan, God, but Lord, your kingdom, your word, your truth, your gospel. God, your way. God, Lord, not the world's gospel, not the world's message. Your message, your truth, God. Lord, let it reign in us, Jesus. God, we pray for your kingdom to come. Lord, we thank you, Jesus.
You said in your word that the kingdom of God does not come through observation over here, over there, running here and there to find God. But the kingdom of God, you said, is within us, Lord. And that's the faith that we need increased, Lord. You said going from glory to glory, faith to faith, glory to glory. Lord, you even spoke to your disciples and said, oh, you of little faith. Because you were telling them the kingdom is in you. Lord, your kingdom is in us. We just have to proclaim your name, proclaim the gospel, proclaim the good news, Lord Jesus, because we have everything you have promised to us. We have it because the kingdom of heaven is here. It's in each and every one of us, Lord. The giftings, the things that we need, the Holy Spirit that will give us the words that we need to speak when we don't know what to say, because the kingdom of God is within us. Amen.
You may find your seats this morning. As our theme has been, let your kingdom come. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 10, it says, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. This is the famous prayer that Jesus prayed, that he taught his disciples to pray. And we want to take a moment right now to pray that God would bring his kingdom to our city, our state, and our country, and our world, and also that his kingdom would come in this room. So let's lift up our voices together. God, we come before you this morning, God. We pray for your kingdom to come. Jesus, Lord, when your kingdom comes, wonderful things happen. God, Lord, we pray that your mighty works be done in our church and throughout this city, throughout this world, God. Lord, we pray, Jesus, that your hand and your voice and your word would begin to be so strong and powerful throughout our world, throughout our country, would become so influential. Jesus, we need your word above all other messages, all other things that are taught and teachings, God. Your teachings are above all that. Lord, we pray that people would no longer be able to mock you and mock your word. Jesus, we lift you up right now, and we ask, Lord, let your kingdom come. Amen? Amen. Amen. In Matthew chapter 16, verse 21, from that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and the chief priests and the scribes and be killed and raised the third day. So at this time, Jesus is on earth and he is sharing that he's going to be killed. He's sharing with his disciples that he's going to be killed and that he will be raised on the third day. Luke chapter 9, verse 30. Two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared in glorious splendor talking with Jesus. They spoke about his departure, which he was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. You got to remember, when Jesus came, he had a purpose and a goal. and he was bringing it to pass. His death and his resurrection were all part of his plan when he came, God with us, Emmanuel, from the very beginning when he was born on earth 2,000 years ago. He was bringing it to fulfillment. And these two men, Moses and Elijah, were there talking with Jesus. John chapter 19, 28. Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, "I thirst." And a vessel of sour wine was sitting there. They filled it and put it to his mouth, and he drank. In Psalms 69, 21, "They put gall in my food and gave me vinegar for my thirst." And so Christ is fulfilling the last thing in the Old Testament that he came to fulfill in the Word. And he's saying, in the next verse, he says, after he received the sour wine, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head, gave up his spirit. John chapter 19, 28 confirms, saying, knowing that all things were now accomplished. God set out to accomplish everything in the Old Testament that was prophesied of him, and he did it. And there, the last thing was to drink that vinegar, and he said, "It is finished." And he brought to pass his plan to die on the cross on earth. But in heaven, in Revelation 13, 8, all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb, slain from the foundation of the world. In his kingdom, Christ in heaven has already died. So 2,000 years ago, God brought his kingdom to earth, and he fulfilled what has already happened in heaven. Very important that we understand this. The disciples responded in Matthew chapter 16, verse 22. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, "Far be it from you, Lord, this shall not happen to you." When Jesus said he's going down to Jerusalem to be killed and raised the third day, this was Peter's response. "This shall not happen to you." And he turned aside to Peter. He said, "Get behind me, Satan, you're an offense to me. You are not mindful of the things of God, but the things of men." And if you sit back, if you were in Peter's situation, you're with Jesus, you see him doing miracles, you see that his word is powerful, and you hear him say, "What? You're going to go and be killed? You're going to go and die?" You might be incredulous yourself, saying, "You want to do what, God? But you have all this power. You can do miracles. I just saw you transfigure yourself. You're brighter than the sun. And you're going to go and die? That doesn't make sense, God." Sometimes God doesn't make sense to us. Sometimes when he comes and he does something, we don't understand, what are you doing? It doesn't line up with what we think he should do. So it's important that we not be mindful of the things of men, but be mindful of the things of God. Don't let men's doctrines get in the way of what God can do. Don't let men's doctrines get in the way of the scriptures, of truth, of what the scriptures say. Matthew chapter 17, verse 1. "He was transfigured, and Peter answered and said, 'Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, let us make here three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah.'" So Peter's response to Christ being transfigured was to make a tabernacle. And Jesus told him that he was going to go to Jerusalem and be killed. So here, Peter's still fixated on the things of men. "I have to make a building," he says. "I got to make a tabernacle. I got to make something physical." And Jesus is saying, "No, I don't have to make a building. I have to make a statement. And after I make my statement, I'm going to make and build my church." If you think about a company has what's called a mission statement. And the mission statement is the purpose, the values, and the goals of a company. And Jesus came to make his statement on which to build his company, that is the church. Do you need a mission? Do you need a mission statement? Jesus has made his statement, and he has been making his church ever since. I encourage you this morning, join his corporation. Get to work. Start growing. The job opportunities in his company are many. Matthew 17:5, a voice came out of the cloud saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him." So God confirms what Jesus said. Hear him. Christ has come to make a statement. We've got to listen to his word, obey his word, obey, make his word our priority, his goals our priority. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a special force. Luke chapter 2, verse 8. There were shepherds keeping watch over their flock by night, and behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. So here these shepherds were out in the field, in the pasture, and all of a sudden, what has come to them? The kingdom has come to them. God, let your kingdom come. The angel said, "Do not be afraid. I will bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be for all the people." We know this scripture. We just read it during Christmas. "This is born, for unto you is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." You notice how the angel said, "You will find." What does that mean? Go and find him. And I was looking through the story, like, when did the angel say, you know, go and find Jesus? Right there. You will find. Go and find him. And suddenly there was the angel, a multitude of the heavenly hosts. There was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So the kingdom has come in this case. And it appeared to the shepherds here. And the angels are telling them, go and find this Jesus Christ. It is important for us to respond in Christ this way. You cannot go throughout your life expecting Jesus to go search you out and go after you. Remember, Jesus, as we have learned, he is passing by. He passes by in your life. And you have an opportunity, and you have a choice whether or not you're going to reach out and receive him and grab him. Amen? Very important that we respond. Colossians chapter 1:15, "The Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation, for in him all things were created, in heaven, on earth, visible and invisible. All things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things are held together." I bring this scripture up again because Christ is the firstborn over all creation. So in his kingdom and in heaven, Christ has already been born. He is before all things. And so at this time of him being born on earth, it is the kingdom of God coming. It is God doing his will on earth as it has already been done in heaven, just like him being slain at the beginning of the world. Amen? John 1:1, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. The Word was God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. We beheld his glory, the glory of the as of the only begotten of the Father. I'm just confirming here what Colossians is saying. Jesus Christ is, he was at the beginning. He is the Word that was made flesh, the Son of God. In John chapter 8:56, in speaking to the religious Jews, he said, "Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad." Abraham was up in heaven and he was watching all this take place. He already saw God, Jesus. He saw the copies and the images of Jesus and God. One's a copy of the other. And he saw that God was going down, Emmanuel, to be made, to be flesh. And he was glad. And the Jews said, "You're not 50 years old, and have you seen Abraham?" And Jesus said, "Before Abraham was, I am." So again, we're just confirming here that in God's kingdom and in heaven, it has already been done. Christ has already already existed. He was already slain from the foundation of the world. And when his kingdom came on earth, these things were fulfilled. Luke chapter 2:15. The shepherds said, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing." When they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And so we see here that they responded. Their response was right. They went and sought out Jesus. "Let us go now and see this thing. Let's go find him." They made the right choice. Are we going and finding Christ? Are we searching him out through prayer, through fasting, through worship, through going and being involved in his house? Those things right there, and putting his word in you. That is how you can seek him out. Hebrews chapter 12:22. "You have come to Mount Zion, to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem. You have come to thousands upon thousands of angels in joyful assembly, to the church of the firstborn." I bring this up because the church, that is us, has thousands of angels in joyful assembly. And just like these shepherds experienced the heavenly host coming, singing glory to God in the highest, the church now is that fulfillment. God has let his kingdom come, and in his church, we have those angels in our assembly. We must recognize how powerful God's house is. Mark chapter 1:14. Jesus came, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel." I encourage you this morning. I want to remind you this morning. If you haven't turned from darkness, if you haven't turned from sin, it's time to keep that going. You're going to have to keep that up for a long time. If you have hell sins in your life, it's time to turn from those hell sins. Repent. Believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ, his gospel was, when the rich man came to him and said, "Lord, how do I get in? How do I receive eternal life?" And Jesus replied and said, "What? Keep the commandments." And his other simple saying here, the simple message is, repent. Turn from the kingdom of darkness. Turn from sin. Turn from those things that are hurting others. Matthew 12:28. "If I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you." So when Jesus came, he brought the kingdom with him. We must surrender our commitment to the world's company, the corporation of the world, the kingdom of the world, the world's message. And we must commit ourselves to Christ's corporation, to his mission statement. And repentance is part of that. making his disciples, making disciples of all nations is part of that. Haggai chapter 2, verse 6. I will shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and dry land. I will shake all nations. The desire of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, and in this place will I give peace. Now, just a reminder again, in heaven, there is a people that are already giving thanks and praise, giving honor, giving glory to the King of Kings and God Almighty. There is already an assembly in heaven. And if Christ, if God can bring about the fulfillment of His death on the cross, bring about the fulfillment of His birth on the earth, and bring the will of God down to earth, then God can make His latter house greater than the former. If God brought His kingdom back then, He can bring His kingdom today. Ephesians 5:27, that He might present to Himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing. This is the goal at the end. This is where Christ wants to bring His church, a glorious church. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. In Revelation chapter 21, verse 2. Colossians 1:22. I present you holy in His sight, without blemish and free from accusation. God wants us He wants to mold us into a church that is glorious. And I submit to you today, as I've already said, if Christ can bring His kingdom in the past, He can bring His kingdom today. And He can bring His kingdom in your life right now. You don't have to wait for God to bring His kingdom in America and in the world in 2024. You can invite His kingdom to you personally in your life. Don't wait for His kingdom to come to America and to the world. Don't wait. Invite His kingdom in your life now. I tell you that you are Peter. On this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not overcome it, shall not prevail. John 17, verse 21, that they all may be one, as you, Father, art in me, and I in you, that you also may be one in us, that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory which you give me, I have given them, that they may be what? One. Can you believe that the church and all of its factions can be brought back together in one? I tell you right now, in heaven, I want to remind you, there is an assembly of billions of people already in heaven, and there is no denomination in heaven. There is no separation in heaven. They are one. When they give glory and honor, they sing in one accord. They give glory to God in one accord. And God can let His kingdom come that is already in heaven and bring it to earth and unite the whole church before He comes. He has done it in the past, and He will do it again. But don't wait for that time. You can have the kingdom of God yourself. Remember what Miss Woods already prophesied and prayed this morning. The kingdom of God is where? Within you. And we can have the kingdom of God. We don't have to wait for the special time. We don't have to wait for the time that God chooses. You remember Jesus was born 2,000 years ago. He died 2,000 years ago. It was a specific time in history, and there's going to be a specific time in history when he fulfills all of these things. But don't wait. The kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is within you. It is at hand. It is available to us. So we'd like to invite you this morning, as we end our fast, we want to let his kingdom come and take some time here to respond. Amen? I encourage you this morning. If we remember 1 Corinthians 14, it says that when you come together, come with a prophecy, come with a word, a teaching, come with a tongue, come with something so that it can affect, so that people can be pricked in their heart and changed in their heart and respond and say the glory of God is among you. God is truly among you. As the scripture that we just read, this is Mount Zion. Amen? Amen? So I invite you to stand with me. We're going to invite our God right now. We're going to take some time to invite His Spirit. And don't wait for me this morning. I would ask that you guys go around and pray for one another. Lift up your voice and put your hands on people. Ask that the Spirit of God would come upon them. Ask that His love, His power, His truth, everything. Ask God to do a mighty work in the body this morning. The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here, oh God. The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place. Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us, oh Lord. You're the reason we came to encounter your love. Your love surrounds us. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done here as in heaven. We're going to take some time this morning. Just want you to reach out to your neighbor as we join hands or put your hand on one another this morning and pray that the kingdom of God would come to them. Pray that God would rise up in them a mighty warrior, a chosen generation. Let's pray for one another right now. God, Lord, we pray, Jesus, we lift up one another. Jesus, 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 Lord, that you would come with your Holy Spirit. God, Lord, that you would baptize us. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, God. Jesus, Jesus, we look to you this morning. Jesus, we call on you this morning, God. Jesus, we ask that your kingdom would come like it came in Acts. Lord, like it came when you were born, God. Jesus, like it came, Jesus. Lord, oh Lord, we call on you this morning. Lord, we pray for one another, God. We lift up our voices to one another. Come with your mighty power. Come, Holy Spirit, Jesus. Please, we call on you this morning. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Holy Spirit, move. Holy Spirit, move, God. Spirit, God. Lord, we invite you this morning. We invite you, God. Oh, Lord, do your mighty work. Oh, Lord, do your mighty work. Jesus, do your mighty work. Oh, Lord. Jesus, we call on you, oh, Lord. Bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing. All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing. You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all, Jesus, for from you are all things. And to you are all things. Oh, you deserve the glory. Oh, God, you are worthy of it all. God, Jesus, you are worthy of it all. Jesus, for from you are all things. And to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Praise the Lord. Praise His name, oh Lord. Lord, we honor you. Jesus, Jesus. Lord, we exalt you. God, we lift you up, Lord, right now. Jesus, Jesus. We want to pray and lift up our voices for one another that the kingdom of darkness would be dispersed from us, that the power of the kingdom of darkness, the scriptures say that God, Jesus, has given us authority, all authority over scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. And we want to pray and ask that God would fulfill that this morning in our hearts, in our lives. So lay your hands. If you this morning want some special prayer, healing, whatever it may be, or a darkness, just come forward or lift up your hand, and we will pray and lift up our voices that God would do His work in your life, the body. Let's lift up your hand. Let's pray for one another right now. Jesus, we call on you this morning. Jesus, we pray, Lord, first of all, Lord, that you, Lord, with your great brightness, Lord, with your great truth and brightness, God, that you would disperse all darkness with your light. God, oh God, Lord, you are the light of the world. Jesus, there is no darkness. Lord, you disperse all darkness with your eyes. God, Lord, you are powerful. Jesus, we pray, we lift them up right now. We lift up our church right now. God, Lord, let your darkness, Lord, be dispersed and scattered and have no more hold over our bodies, over our heart, over our mind. Jesus, Jesus, come. Holy Spirit, we call on you this morning. Holy Spirit, we call on you this morning. God, let your hand come upon us this morning. Oh, Spirit of the living God, we call on you. Oh, God, we look to you this morning. Jesus, healer. Oh, King of kings, Emmanuel. Oh, God, we pray, Lord, let your light shine, Lord. Lord, defeat and Lord, beat back the oppressor in our lives. Jesus, Jesus, you have come that we would have life and life more abundantly. Oh, Lord, we want to surrender to you. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, Lord, you're worthy. Oh, Spirit of God, we call on you. We thank you this morning. Lord, oh, Lord, King of kings. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Come with your mighty hand, God. Lord, we constrain you this morning, God. Do not pass by, oh God. Do not pass us by, Lord. Come. Come with your hand. Come with your touch. Come with your mighty word, oh God. Lord, like the centurion said, Lord, just speak the word. God, speak the word. God, speak your word, oh Lord. Speak your word, oh God. Oh, Jesus, speak your word. Oh, Father, Father, speak your word. Lord, we invite you now, oh God. Oh, Father, speak your word. Oh, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Oh, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Oh, Lord, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Jesus, Jesus, Lord, we invite you right now. Oh, God, come. Spirit of the living God, Spirit of the Lord, we need you, we invite you, oh God, worthy is your name. Oh, worthy is your name. As we have prayed for one another and ourselves this morning, we also want to turn our attention to the world. In our world right now, lies are being, sin is being taught as a truth in the Bible. That it is merciful to abort a child. There's lies going out throughout the world. The world's message is a deception. And they're teaching the next generation lies and trying to twist the scriptures to agree with it. And we need to pray and ask God that His Word, that He would work with His Word. That His Word would go out. That His kingdom would come. That people would hear Him like God came and said in the cloud. Let's lift up our voices right now and just pray for our world. That God, His Word would become clear. That His kingdom would come and His law would be followed. Lord Jesus, we pray right now. God, Lord, in your kingdom, Lord, you reign. God, you are majesty. God, Lord, your law is truth. Jesus, Jesus, and we all surrender to that law. Lord God, we pray right now. Lord, let your kingdom come to this earth, O Lord. Lord, let it be on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, that your word, your truth, God, we begin to become so influential throughout the world. God, so influential throughout America. God, Lord, we pray that you revive your word, O Lord. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, O Lord, the kingdom of darkness has risen, and they have spoken their blasphemy. Lord, they have spoken their untruths. God, O God, and Lord, we pray that you would let your kingdom come. Lord, that you would work with your word. Lord, that you would work with your mighty word and speak your truth. Lord, your word that disperses all darkness, your word that disperses all, Lord, kingdoms of darkness, God, principalities and powers, God, they cannot stand before your word. God, oh Lord, they were formed by your word, and they can be beaten back and destroyed by your word. God, please. God, please, we pray. Jesus, unravel the lies with your word, your powerful word of truth. Jesus, a living word, oh Lord God, please. We pray for your kingdom. Lord, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Oh Lord, we call on you this morning. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Oh, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing, you are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. For from you are all things, to you are all things, you deserve the glory. I'm going to ask somebody to grab that mic, and I'm going to ask somebody to lift up their voice in prayer right now. Prophecy, prayer, whatever it may be, just please lift up, let the Spirit of God move through you, speak through you. Whatever God has put on your heart, Let His Spirit work in us this morning. Just speak out.
Oh Lord, today we gather together, Lord, to worship you, Lord Jesus. As it is in heaven, Lord, we worship you here today.
Yes, Jesus.
Making this place
Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Those online, we want to thank you for joining us this morning. We trust you understand the message. That God has already fulfilled things in heaven. And when He brings His kingdom on earth, He's going to do great and mighty things. You don't have to wait for the time to come. You don't have to wait for the year or the date to come. Jesus says Himself, the kingdom of God is at hand. And the scriptures say, Paul wrote and said, the kingdom of God is within you. I encourage you this morning, do not wait for God's kingdom to come. Have it in your own life today. And also, make a goal in your life to bring the kingdom of God to other people. God bless you. Thank you for joining us.